Hi all and welcome back. Let's jump straight into it today. The topic at hand, Jabra Enhance Select 700. So Jabra just dropped the 700 for $1,995, replacing the older 500 model. That makes 700 Jabra's new flagship OTC hearing aid, and it's marketed as their best solution for noise, thanks to advanced noise and spatial processing features like their soundscape autofocus. Stick around because in this video, we'll cover my hands-on experiences, our objective lab testing, and of course, sound samples so you can hear 700 with your own ears. Now, Jabra is no stranger to hearing aids. In fact, much of their technology comes directly from their partners, G and Resound. Now, at least to me, this sometimes makes Jabra products feel like prescription hearing aids in disguise because it's kind of what they are. For example, Jabra Enhance 700 pull from the same tech as Resound's latest Vivia lineup. To make things even more confusing, I suppose, at least to me, is that Jabra also sells hearing aids through Costco under the Enhance Pro line. So you might be wondering, are these devices all the same? Well, we'll touch on that in just a bit. But first, here's a quick rundown of the Enhance Select 700. They offer hands-free calling with compatible iOS and Android devices, 24-hour rechargeable battery life. There is plenty of customization through the Jabra Enhance Select app, plus remote audiologic services. There's no telecoil, and they have an IP68 rating. Before we dive into the box, let's look at how the 700 scored in our testing. Overall, Enhance Select 700 received a hearing tracker score of 4.1 out of 5, and this is very similar to other Jabra products and Resound Vivia. All right, at least for now, enough about numbers. Let's crack the box open and see what you get. All right, inside the box, you will find various user documents tucked away in this top sleeve. I know we all love our user documents, but there are these numbered cards, and these are definitely worth looking through. They'll walk you through the devices, your warranty, what's in the box. But let's take a look at the case. To be honest, I really do like this Resound Jabra portable charging case. It is very sturdy. It works well. You can see here there are LED indicators showing you the battery status of the hearing aids. The LED light on the hearing aids lights up when they're charging. And if we look at the back, there's also LED light indicators for the battery status of the case itself. Digging a little bit deeper in the box, we have these wax guards. And as you can see, there are many different ear tips or domes you can choose among, and be sure to speak with your Jabra provider to help you narrow down what is the right size and style for you. Here are microphone filters for the back of your hearing aids. And of course, some cleaning tools, a microfiber cloth, and a multi-use tool, which has a brush and a little pick on the other end that you can't really see because it's tucked behind the cloth. Now, these weird looking things are called sports locks, or rather, I like to call them kickstands because, like a kickstand, they help keep the speaker portion of your hearing aid that you can see me here pointing to. They help keep that down in your ear, and this helps with retention, sound quality, and even feedback. You will also find a USB-A to USB-C cable. It does come with the wall plug, and you can simply just plug the USB-A end into the wall plug and then the USB-C end into the back of the portable charging case. Now, 700 also support wireless app control and audio streaming via Bluetooth low energy, like we've already discussed. This is expected since Jabra's tech is based on GN's prescription hearing aids, and that means stable wireless performance. That's important because, at least me, I don't like jumping through hoops for hearing aids and or just in general for technology that's meant to make my life easier. And Jabra are honestly great here. I find them very reliable and I don't run into any connection issues once I get that initial pairing. But let's take a closer look at the Enhance Select mobile app. First things first, let's get the app opened and it will prompt you through the connection process. We're going to take the hearing aids out and put them back in to just make sure they are restarted. And now we'll need to go to our iPhone settings or our phone settings. And if this is your first time connecting your hearing aids, we go to Accessibility, Hearing Devices, and this is where we can connect devices through MFI. And be sure your hearing aids are out of the case so they're in pairing mode. It'll take a moment, but my phone should establish connection, and here we can see them Steve's hearing aids. So we'll click on that. It'll ask us to pair once for each hearing aid. And here we have access to some native controls directly through our phone, such as volume, we can adjust the treble bass, various streaming functions, we can also change programs, and if you are an iPhone user, you will see Live Listen, which turns your phone into a remote microphone. Now, Jabra offers various wireless accessories that will offer similar wireless functionality. So let's head back to the app. And at this point, the app should establish a connection. It's going to make us jump through a few hoops by putting our hearing aids back in and taking them back out. This is honestly a little annoying, but once you do it the first time, you should not have to do it ever again. Great, so now we're in the app. One quick note, the Jabra app thinks I'm streaming anytime I screen record, so this will look a little different, but overall the same. Here we can see me switching between the various programs. We can also do that directly from our hearing aids by pressing and holding the button, and you can see that here. It'll work with either hearing aid for what it's worth. And then if we click that sound equalizer button, we gain access to this 3-band EQ. Now again, I'm streaming, so yours will look a little different unless you're also streaming, but this allows us to control the bass, middle, and treble. For what it's worth, we can also adjust the programs by clicking on these icons at the top of the screen. So if we go to the Care tab, this is where we can access all of the audiology or telehealth services. We can send emails, request professional adjustments, book our video appointment. The Help tab does just that, and it offers some helpful FAQs, general links. We can also directly access the Jabra store, so if we want to order some accessories or extra supplies, we can do that. There's not much in the Account tab other than, well, your account information. We can also access various settings, so if I click the little gear icon on the top of the app screen, we'll see that I actually do have some settings that I can install on my hearing aid. Now, there are a few more nuances, but that is the Jabra Enhance Select mobile app in a nutshell. Okay, this is actually a great point to break and talk about Jabra's telehealth or remote audiology services. This is actually one of Jabra's biggest strengths. With the app, you can connect directly to a licensed audiologist for remote adjustments, video visits, ongoing support, and more. I'll be honest, Jabra's telehealth program is one of the best in the OTC space, at least right now. While their overall support has been, let's say, questionable in the past with long wait times, I've found it to improve at least the past few times I've tried their products. But if your experiences have been different, let us all know in the comments below. As always, part of my reviews include objective testing from HearAdvisor. Every device, whether OTC or prescription, is tested using the same protocol and a common age-related hearing loss. Check out this scorecard. You can see how 700 performed across HearAdvisor's 5 sound quality metrics and 2 fitting paradigms. 700 received a sound grade of B, making it very competitive and just at the threshold of being a top performing device this year. Now, that said, I want to pause here for just a moment because this is interesting and honestly left me scratching my head. Jabra's 700 speech and noise performance isn't great. And that is honestly surprising given that their technology comes from GN Resound. Now, some possible reasons? Well, the predictive models HearAdvisor uses to estimate speech benefits may not fully capture the nuances of their specific noise reduction features. It's possible. Alternatively, it's also conceivable that some of their audio processing may not deliver as expected when put in real-world situations. Now I'm talking diffuse noise, multi-talker environments like we use for testing at HearAdvisor. It could also be a mix of both. Now personally, I have noticed some odd performance in loud environments, and by that I mean both in the lab and while testing these devices throughout my life. So there's nothing definitive yet, and GN's technology is overall solid. But this is something we're continuing to investigate, both internally and with GN's research team. Honestly, if there's any way for us to help their technology or for them to help us with the data we share with all of you, I'd consider that a win-win. But let's listen to some sound files so you can hear Jabra 700 with your own ears. If a picture is worth 1,000 words, a sound file must be worth something. I've honestly been trying to think of an appropriate age for that. So if you're feeling cerebral or poetic, maybe help me out and finish the line for me. Anyway, we'll be listening to a typical cafe setting, and you'll first hear the cafe environment without any hearing aids.
Did you hear the news last night?
No, I must have missed it.
Looks like we're finally getting a break. I mean, it's supposed to be sunny all weekend.
Oh, yeah? Perfect timing. Maybe I can finally get out there and do some yard work.
Yard work? My mind went to breaking up the grill.
Well, that too. The lawn isn't going to cut itself, and the bushes have gotten a little crazy.
I guess that's true. I mean, I've been putting an understanding on deck.
This year, maybe a year.
Trees, bushes, deck. We'll just have to dream about the grill and the huge ice cooler.
Next up, streaming quality. We'll play the original audio track, then the same song streamed through the 700 at both our initial and tune fits. Okay, so how do Jabra Enhance Select 700 hold up? For $1,995, are they worth the cost? Well, I would say it depends on what you value. At this price point, you can also buy premium hearing aids, including those designed by Jabra, at Costco. Now, these will come with in-person care and verifications like real ear measurements, and that's not worth nothing. That said, if you want a high-end, direct-to-consumer option with excellent remote audiology, solid build quality, strong wireless features, discreet design, and more, well, Enhance Select 700 may be a great fit for you. You can also find accessories like the TV streamer and multi-mic, which can improve your listening experiences in those unique situations. Some key pros are they are extremely undeniably discreet. It is surprising how small 700 are given the tech that is packed inside. Jabra also offers excellent support. You'll get some of the best, if not the best, in-class telehealth services. They're also very user-friendly. Jabra 700 are just easy to use with stable wireless streaming, great overall build and sound quality, as well as that useful app control that we've already discussed. Now, on the other side of that coin, Jabra Enhance Select 700 are expensive for over-the-counter hearing aids. Similar money could get you prescription hearing aids with in-person care. Additionally, some other lower-cost OTC devices may offer you more help in those complex listening environments. As we've mentioned already, while Jabra 700 sound good overall, our testing suggests that noise processing is not quite on par with some other modern hearing aids. Last but not least, remote-only support also means no in-person verifications like probe tube measurements. So, as true with all OTC devices, it's unclear how much benefit you are getting and whether any benefit is left on the table. But that's it for today's review. If you want more information, you can check out my full review at hearingtracker.com. All right. That's a wrap. Thanks for watching.